Hi, everyone.
Hello, everyone.
Happy Sunday fun day.
Yes, indeed. It is that time again. Time for wine, women, and song. Yeah. This is actually episode number 27.
Yes.
On a very hot and balmy Sacramento summer day. I am Shonda, aka the Princess.
And I am Eva, the Rockabilly Diva.
And we're really glad you could join us today. As usual, we have a whole bunch of music stuff to talk about.
Yeah.
Some exciting shows that we went to that we'll be discussing.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, we have our local booze. So, as always, every episode, we invite you to also drink with us. It is Sunday Fun Day.
Yes.
So, we have some really delicious wine this week. And I picked this up really in our neighborhood market here, Taylor's Market. You know, they're kind of known for a lot of imported wines.
Fancy. It's a fancy market.
And more fancy kind of wines. But, you know, we always drink local or regional.
Yes.
We drink California made only. So this particular wine is Malene. I think I'm saying that correctly, hopefully.
Yes.
And it is a rosé, and it is a 2018 rosé. It was really affordable. It was only $16, so easy peasy. And it is from San Luis Obispo, which is our beautiful Central mm-hmm. California coast.
Yeah.
So, to go with our coastal wine, and this really hot ass Sacramento day.
Oh my God,
we were both melting.
It was so hot yesterday.
It was so miserable.
So
this weekend is like
today.
It's like record temps. It's like heat warning advisory, whatever. But anyway, I thought, what would be better than mm-hmm. some like summertime tunes with the Beach Boys?
Yeah.
So this is our final of the week, final of the week.
Ooh.
And it is the Beach Boys. It's like it's a greatest hits. I purchased this at our favorite Armadillo Records in Davis, California, from Mr. Paul Wilbur, at one of his vinyl nights, which he does that twice a month over at 3 Mile Brewing in Davis. So if you're a vinyl head and you want to pick up some new records, Paul always brings out like just weird, interesting mixes of music, and you can always like pick something up maybe, you know, you hadn't even considered. You know, you listen to it and you're like, a couple of beers in, you're like, I want to buy that. We always do. We always clean them out.
We always buy
everything. So, anyway, so I'll get this going. I'll put some music on. Okay.
And she has to open the wine, too, because I'm not a good wine opener.
And I'm going to open the wine.
So she'll
do that
once she's done with the record.
So this is actually, this is a two-record set, so there's four sides. So we'll start it off with side one. Yeah, and it kind of spans, like, the whole Beach Boys, you know, they did a lot of number one hits, right? They're really, obviously successful band. I think that's perfect.
A good one, yeah.
I think that's just so perfect. Yes. Anyway, so okay. The Malene wine, we're gonna get that open. Hopefully it's got one of those cuckoo.
And just so everyone knows, we're both running a little slow today. Like it wasn't because we partied down or anything, but the heat
is just hot.
It's really, really bad.
Yes.
So yeah, so if we're just kind of, it's
that's
because
why. Our brains are scrambled.
Yes, they are.
We are at a disadvantage. It was 105? 105 yesterday. It's supposed to be, I think, similar today.
I mean, when I woke up this morning, I had my door open, and it was my slider with a fan, and it was blowing in hot air at like 8 o'clock.
So
I'm like,
I hope you guys out there are all keeping cool. If you're in Northern California, I'm sorry for you, with you.
truth.
Yeah. All right. So, got it open. Got our fancy flutes. I usually drink, you know, out of my flamingo glasses or my blue wine glasses, but this is so pretty in pink. So I wanted to be able to show the color of this pretty wine. I feel like it's really summery and light, and it's chilled. Really chilled.
Yes.
Taylor's had it nice and cold.
Oh, it is cold.
Yay!
Well, cheers. Happy
cheers.
Sunday.
Happy Sunday fun day.
Very dry.
It's very dry.
Which is nice. It's got a little...
Okay.
I feel like it's cidery.
Okay, so my first reaction, it tastes a little bit like... This is maybe not the nicest thing to say, but it tastes like when you've left the champagne out for a while, you know, and it goes flat, like the bottle's been open and it's the end of the night and you're me and you're going to drink the rest of the bottle. It tastes a little bit like that. Like it's just like a, so maybe that's not a terrible thing. If you're a wine person and you love champagne and you like the flavor of champagne, this might be something you really enjoy because it tastes like champagne. It's very dry.
Yeah, it tastes like champagne. I guess that's what I'm...
Yeah, it doesn't look like how you would think it would taste. Did I say that right?
Yeah.
But it's like, it's very dry. I don't taste much fruit in it. There's not like a whole lot of...
It does taste like champagne. Like Andre. Pink champagne.
Oh, snap! But we're still gonna drink it! Not that we ever drink Andre champagne.
That is my teenage years.
Totally. No, yeah. I still drink it.
Because it was like $5.
I don't care.
And then you could sneak it in your backyard and your mom never knew.
Yeah. And at parties and stuff, everybody always has that. Like, yeah. They always have, you know, because it's
the cold, there's a cold duck one too, right?
The pink one, though. It's all about the pink one.
I know, the pink one.
It does kind of taste like that.
It is Andre.
Yeah.
Malene from
San Luis Obispo.
You taste like pink Andre champagne.
You know, I wonder too, because here's the thing, you guys. I typically drink red wine. Anybody who knows me, I love red wine. So I don't know that much about, honestly, about like drinking white wines. I don't know.
It is a rosé,
but I don't, outside of the red realm, I don't know a lot of things. So I don't know, does this have to aerate? Maybe somebody who knows about wine knows that you have to like, because with red wine, when you open it, if you just pour it and drink it, it's like even good wine.
I don't know, let me call my best friend Lisa Vanderpump. She has a rosé out on the market.
Really?
You know, she's one of my reality show people that I watch and I'm obsessed with because she does all this rad stuff with animals, dogs.
Oh, okay.
Like the Chinese like meat trade thing, she like saves dogs.
I have a friend. So who I love it. Too,
that she's awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So anyway, that was off topic.
Random.
Super random.
You can count on it with us. You can count on it.
So where should we get started? Should we get started? Okay, so why we're dressed up today. We probably said it last week, I think.
Mm-hmm. So, well, number one, it's just hot as you know what, as we've already covered, and I just don't want to wear a lot of clothes today because it's so hot. So, you know, the tiki dress is a go-to. This is an oldie but a goodie for me. And, you know, the hair up, no hair situation because it's just too hot for hair today. But we wanted to also mention, as we did last week, Sundays in Sacramento are Ohana Sundays over at the Jungle Bird. So if you have, you know, some time this afternoon and you'd like a little tropical getaway, you want to go hang out in the air conditioning, have a really frosty beverage, the Jungle Bird on J Street here in Sac is having their Ohana Sunday. It's at 4:00 every Sunday. And this Sunday is extra specially special because they're doing a Kevin Murray mug release today, and it started at noon, but I'm assuming like the whole Ohana people will be there and getting their mugs, and hopefully they're not sold out. It's supposed to go till tomorrow, so if you can't make it out there today, you can still go tomorrow and get your new mug. I should have got my mug. Off topic again. Random. I went to Disneyland this last week. If you guys are following me on Instagram, yes. I had a whirlwind trip with my family to Disneyland. But my favorite part of Disneyland these days, now that the kids are a little older and they can kind of go off on their own, is the Trader Sam's Tiki Bar. And I was kind of stoked because I've got 4 mugs from Trader Sam's so far. But this week I picked up the blue piranha.
Yeah, that looked really cool.
I was pretty stoked. I'll show it to you guys next week.
Yeah.
But mugs. We're just busy collecting. That's what summer's about, right? Tiki drinks,
collecting,
tiki parties,
putting flowers in your hair and being hotter than you
wearing
are.
Way too many flowers. Yeah.
We
have fun.
So yeah, you went. She was gone all week. I was dying. I did not. Well, I did go to a
show.
Yeah,
you had some fun this week.
Did I go to one show only? Yeah, I went to one show. Well, 2 shows.
I was gonna say Friday. You went to Cherry Kings. The Diana and the Cherry Kings.
Oh, I went to 3 shows.
Diana and the Cherry Kings played at the State Fair this year. This was the 3rd year that they were asked back, so it was kind of a big deal. We were very proud of our Diana.
Yes, absolutely.
We absolutely love and adore her, and we're so happy and proud that her band is continuing and it's evolving and it's growing, and we love good rockabilly music, and they got it going on, so yes, we were super stoked for them. I wish I could have gone. They have wine slushies, which I was so
jealous. I had some wine slushies.
Jealous.
Oh, so good.
It looks so good.
So good.
I think that's the only way you could even...
So you can get a mix of them, or you can get them just whatever. So they have a rosé, they have a strawberry wine, and they have a black... berry wine, which is going to be the dark
like
red
a sangria
wine.
Sangria kind of a deal?
No,
was it fruity?
It's now, yeah, it's very sweet. It's very sweet.
Okay.
This year I did the strawberry and rosé mix, and it was so good. But sometimes I'll do the blackberry
so
and strawberry
good.
Mix.
Ooh.
And it's super good, but the blackberry is sweeter than the other ones. The other ones are a little drier.
More dry, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So that's why I didn't go for the blackberry. I think it's blackberry.
Can you make a wine slushy suicide?
Ooh.
I know, right?
And then this year I decided to get their, like, they were selling like a mug, like a with a lid and a straw.
Oh, cool.
And when you went back, you could get a discounted...
did you do it?
I did.
Oh, okay.
But I only got 2 wine slushies. I mean, if I would have gone more, it would have been worth it.
So you're feeling like maybe you didn't get your money's worth?
I did, because it is the big one. But, yeah, next year definitely I'll go early, get a mug, and maybe try to go a couple times. Just, you know.
Oh, so you can take it back multiple days?
Yeah, because it's for this year's.
Oh,
so if you're,
cool.
like, one of those people that go to the fair all the time.
That's a good
you
way to
can,
save a little money.
Yeah.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah. I'm like, can we use it this next year? And she's like, well, it has the dates. And I'm all,
oh,
damn it.
They want to sell you another mug,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, they want to sell us another mug.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that was fun. Yeah, that show was really fun, and that happened on Thursday, and it was later in the evening, so it was cooler.
Yeah.
There was a nice breeze. We had our Delta breeze that night.
And it was all covered,
reason.
Right?
And it was covered.
That was
usually
good.
They have the misters. They didn't have misters on this year. I think because it was covered and later,
okay,
it was like cooler. Nice and cooler. Yeah.
And it was before the hot as balls heat
yes.
wave that we're now currently
oh,
experiencing. It's so miserable.
So miserable.
Lord, you just gotta hide.
So I was, yesterday it was 105 and I kept getting messages on my phone. Are you going to midnight mass? Are you? I'm all, nope. It's 105. I'm
yeah.
not walking around
no,
in
on the
this heat.
And no.
yeah, no, no, no.
It looks like
I have
everybody
friends.
Who braved the heat, it
yeah.
looks like you had a fun time. We're stoked for you that
yes.
you had fun. It looked like, you know, it looked like a good big party. It looked
yeah.
really fun. I'm looking at you, Raymond. I'm looking at you.
JT went
and
later,
JT,
though.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, he called me about probably 8 o'clock.
Okay.
And he's like, I just got here. He's like, I had to wait for it to cool down.
You know,
believe me, it wasn't cooled down
no,
at 8 o'clock.
You know what? At midnight last night, it was 81 degrees. Midnight. It was crazy hot.
I was pool partying yesterday.
I know. Those
and
pictures look so fun.
You know
fun.
What?
What?
The pool was warm.
Can't even
but, you know, it's
pool.
Okay. Yeah. We did some...
an uncool pool.
what is it? Beer pong?
Okay.
So one of the girls that came over, she brought a hostess gift, right? It's a hostess gift?
Yeah, yeah.
And so she brought a pool beer pong.
Okay.
So
well,
it was really fun.
Fun.
I've never done that before.
Oh, very cool.
So it was fun.
You got in the pool and you played games?
Yeah.
I'm proud
and
of you.
And I was wearing my bikini. I mean, not my bikini, but I borrowed a bikini.
Diana's.
And
yeah.
I didn't even care. I had no shame yesterday because
no
it was so hot.
Given. I'm
I was
proud
like,
of you.
I don't care.
That's good. That
yeah.
sounds like fun.
Yay. So, anyway, so you were gone this
uh-huh.
week. I went to a great show at the Momo Lounge.
Yes.
It was like a like punk, surf punk, this local band
now that was
called, it was Tuesday.
Okay.
This local band called Las Pulgas.
Yeah, that looked really cute and cool.
The girls are so cute, and the guys that play in the band are really cool, but the chicks, the lead singer, Marisol.
Oh, that's great.
She is adorable,
yeah.
and she's just a little ball of energy, and, that was really fun, and they opened for Bruiser Queen and Faya. Faya is from San Antonio, Texas, and Bruiser Queen is from, I feel like Chicago, but I could be wrong.
Okay.
You could probably look it up.
Yeah.
Anyway, I picked up the show was really good. Faya is like a chick punk band.
Oh, cool.
They sing in English and Spanish. Bruiser Queen is like a guy and a gal, drums and guitar.
I kind of like a
fucking awesome.
Yeah, I love that. That's like our Jessie.
She is adorable.
Yeah.
And there, I felt like they were a little more poppy, but it was fun. They
how
had some
you be
really
poppy
good
the
tunes. Two-piece?
Like, how poppy can you be?
I mean, maybe it was just her energies.
That's so cool.
I mean, both of them had good energies.
Right on.
So that's I picked awesome. Up some vinyl because, you know, that's what I do. And they're touring, and they're from far, far away. So
always buy the merch.
So I
always buy
a Las Pulgas shirt for my godson.
Aww.
So he could sport it because I have so many t-shirts.
I know
my godson will wear it. So and he's 27 and he listens to everything. And so this is also a way for him to go like, oh yeah, I have this shirt. Who's this band? Let me listen to them. They are on Spotify.
She's trying to corrupt everyone, people.
Yes.
She's a one woman army corrupting.
I'm trying. Yes. So I got two albums and a couple of 45s from Bruiser Queen, and this is their cover.
Oh, very
They're
cool.
They're super cool.
Yeah.
And they have a really good sound, and la la la, y'all know how I love it.
Ooh, colored vinyl. Ooh la la.
So I'm super excited. Since I've been so busy this week, I haven't been able to listen to a whole lot, but I do love to share my colored vinyl, and I believe this is their new one, this one here.
Sweet.
And also, super excited.
Oh, it's so pretty. It's so pretty. Ooh. Wow.
Love, love, love.
That's gorgeous.
So, so I got these two albums from Bruiser Queen, and I also picked up this one, and I don't think it's open. Yes, it is. So they had two 45s, and one of them had multiple colors. She just picked me out a red one. Oh my god, this seems like a
pull
okay.
it out, pull it out.
Let's see, is this the one, the colored red one? I don't know.
This one looks like me.
Oh, this one's just regular.
Okay,
this is one of their little
super cool.
But,
fun at the punk show. Fun.
Oh, here it is. Okay. So this is, this one is a compilation of a bunch of different bands. So I was kind of excited to get this. And it came in different colors. But she said, I want to give you the red one. So look
so
at how
pretty
cool that
is. Blood red. That is
yeah,
so
blood
cool.
red. And it's got like a little marbling
little,
in it.
Yeah, little swirls in there. That's
so
cool.
That is my
so good
Bruiser
show.
Queen. Super good show.
What was your favorite?
My favorite out of all? Well, you know what? I really fell in love with Faya.
Okay, because yeah. you bought the hat.
I did buy a hat.
Yeah.
And I never buy a hat.
Yeah.
So they just have a regular basic album, but their little labels are cool. Like, isn't that a cool label?
Way cool.
Yeah, and they have cool graphics, like super cool graphics. So
it's like
weird.
Some old school punk stuff,
yeah.
like an old GBH album.
Well,
or
and
something.
Then, like I said, they had their cool little hat with the old English writing. It was
yeah,
very,
that was cool.
Like, you know, like
gangster. My daughter would want it.
Yes, totally.
That's awesome. I love it. That's
so that
cool.
was a great show, and I loved all the bands. But like, really, I've never seen Fan before, but I guess they've come through here, and I fell in love with them.
Awesome.
And the girls are all super nice.
Very
so
cool.
nice. All of the bands were nice. So anyway, they will be coming back. Les Pulgas will be playing again. So
oh yeah,
if you,
they're locals, right?
Yes.
So,
they play at the Colonial
like a
Cafe a
yeah.
lot, like for the all ages shows. So if you ever see them on any bill, you should
go check them
out.
Awesome.
And then, like she said, I went to Diana on Thursday. And then on Friday.
What day is it? I don't even know.
On Friday, I went to Cafe Colonial, which is one of our local all-ages venues,
yeah.
punk venue. And they were doing a CBGB tribute.
Yeah, it looks really cool. We talked about it a little bit
yeah.
last week. So they did, you know, all that early CBGB's music, the music that broke at CBGB's, like Talking Heads and
mm-hmm.
Blondie, Dead Boys, Ramones,
and Joan Jett.
Yep.
My friends, the Rowe Brothers band, they did the Blondie set, And Rita did an amazing job. Like, yay, she did a great job. Yay. It was really fun to watch.
Super cool. Yeah. I love it.
And then the Dead Boy set was pretty good, but I was all hot from the first set, so I kind of videoed
and
a little bit.
And you were, like, trying to imagine Ricky Ratt, and you just, and
yes,
you just couldn't do it.
I know. I was just chatting with all the other bands. And then Danny...
Oh, he slayed.
Danny's.
I saw the video, yeah.
Okay, so they did the Talking Heads, and it wasn't
the Moans,
his normal,
the
it
Moans.
Wasn't the yeah. normal Moans band, though.
Oh, okay, all right.
But because Danny is awesome.
And he's a showman of himself.
And he brought the drum kit, so no one else had to bring their drum kit.
Oh,
you know, he did the
backline.
Yes.
Cool.
So that is awesome. Like, yay
How
for
nice.
People that do that.
That guy
That's
supports,
so cool.
like, none of them.
Yeah, so...
Props to him. Props to you, Danny.
So he was adorable. He was wearing, like, a cute little, like...
His
Talking Heads
shirt, outfit.
Yeah. With his glasses and his hair. And he did it all the way. You know, he didn't just sing the song.
Yeah, no, he had the whole look.
He
the
did
videos
the whole
are
thing.
Good. You guys
yes.
can look it up. You know, go to
Danny
Secretions.
Or you can
page
post
and,
some.
Yeah,
too.
We can put it on the
on
YouTube
the Insta or
and
whatever.
On the Insta.
Yeah,
yeah.
But it was so fun. And at the very end, like, of the night, when I said bye, he said, "Thank you so much for standing up there in video taping." Like, he's like, "Thank you so much for watching." Like, he is a great guy, and that was so fun.
I wonder. I mean, I wasn't at that show, so I don't know. But I wonder if the kids, and I mean, you know, people who are under the age of 30, if it just went over their head. Like, do they know? Are they like, "Oh yeah, Talking Heads, Ramones"? You know, do they know, or are they just like? You know, I mean, I feel like for some of those kids, that's probably the first time that they heard some of that music. I don't know.
From what I saw, there was a lot more support from the adult side
so there was
of
a
it.
Whole lot of old folks.
Old folks, yes.
That love that crap.
And
yeah.
there were some people that brought their families that were like 16, maybe a little younger.
Yeah.
But I feel like the parents are into the music, so the kids know about the music. It was that kind of thing. Like, it wasn't just, like, you know, random, like, Laredo schoolgirl going, "I'm going to go to the punk show. CBGB's, cool."
Right. I just feel like a lot of kids don't even know what that is.
Yeah.
What a cool way to kind of introduce them.
Yeah.
Know?
I mean, it was all the good
stuff.
It,
yeah.
I mean, there was a lot of good bands that went through CBGB's, but, like, this was all, like, really,
early.
Yeah, early stuff.
I love that.
So it was really fun. But I had a good
JT's
time.
On there. Hi, JT.
And then I went and had some drinks at my favorite Arthur Henry's with the Roa Brothers band.
Secret Screw.
Yes, we all sat there. It was their first time there.
Oh, cool.
So we had a good time and we closed out the bar.
Party,
so,
party.
Yeah, that was fun. And
awesome.
Then yesterday again, like, I just sat in the pool all day.
Yeah.
And listened to music and beer.
I did get to cram in some music at Disneyland when I was at the Trader Sam's. You know, they often on the little lanai outside, they have, you know, different acts rotating. And it was, I will be posting the video on YouTube for anybody who wants to see it. But there was a band there, a two piece. They are from Oahu. Their father was a musician from Oahu. Their father, like, wrote songs. They're called Malta Nui. And they are like brothers, and they are like awesome harmonies. I couldn't get enough of it. I think I sat there for 2 hours. I think I watched like two whole sets of their music. But what was really, really bitchin', there was a lady in there from Hawaii that they knew that was a friend, and they called her up, and she did a really beautiful hula dance, like, just in the middle
awesome.
Of the crowd. She just got up and started dancing, and, you know,
oh,
it was so
cool.
magical. And then there was another gal that was in the audience, and I guess she knew the hukilau dance, which is a hula dance, and it's, you know, it's got these certain specific moves. I guess a lot of school kids learn it, because they were talking about, like, one of the fellas in the band had actually taught at elementary schools, like, went in and taught him the song and taught him the dance. Anyway, the guy, the like lead guy, jumped up and danced with a gal from the audience who knew the dance, and just got up there and danced with her, and I got a video of that too.
Oh,
which was
cool.
It was really, I mean, Disneyland really.
You
never
were there a lot. I felt like you didn't weren't in Disney. Like,
I didn't
Disney
want to
per
leave.
Se. I felt like you were at Trader Sam's.
Well, the first night that we got there, like, we were just like, we gotta go, because I wasn't sure if we'd be able to cram it in. So the first night we were there, You know, as soon as we got to Anaheim, we were just like, yeah, we want to go. The daughter wanted to really go and check it out. And it was really funny because she was like, well, I guess so. I guess. And then we get there and they did like, you know, they do, for anyone who has not been to Trader Sam's, they do like, if you order a shipwreck, they're like, no, shipwreck! And they yell and they like bang on some bell and then like the lights flicker and the bartenders grab these squirt bottles and they're like, we're taking on water, and they squirt the audience. It's really fun. The daughter was just like, oh, like I'm all, oh great. I just turned into, I just turned her out into a tiki head. Like I just turned her out. Like she was just like, what even is this? And then they have another drink where they have like these virtual volcanoes on either side of the bar, and the volcanoes erupt. Krakatoa, and then the volcanoes erupt, and it's very entertaining. So yeah, we went. The daughter loved it. The food was really good. She loved it. They have these like deep fried long beans, and they're in like a, it's like a mayonnaise sauce, like
an aioli. Really,
yeah. And the kid was like, she was in love. She, and they have like non-alcoholic beverages, so we got her a little mocktail to go with her tiki experience.
Oh, cool.
And she had a blast. So that was the first night. And then of course, yeah, on the last night that I was there, I think my mom was with us. She was like, I think exhausted, we both were. And it was just like, let's just turn the kids loose. We're kind of all done. It was really hot down there too. Like, of course, we go down there, it's like 96 flipping degrees. I'm like, really? I brought stupid Sacramento with me? So not cool, Southern California. But yeah, so the mom was just like, oh God. I'm so, you know, we were just like whooped. And I was like, let's just go get you some cocktails and sit on the lanai and maybe have some snacks. So that's what we did. And then that band played and there was a little hula.
That's
we
cool.
Ended up, like I said, we ended up sitting there for probably 2.5, maybe 3 hours. I don't even know. Like,
so
we lost
jealous.
Track of time. It was amazing.
So super jealous.
It's really easy though. I will say, when you go to Trader Sam's, like, bring your two wallets, because I'll tell you, like, I burned through like some serious cash, because I mean, everything on the menu is $20, like, you know, $14 to $20, like, so
when
it's
you
like,
get a drink, it's $14, you get food, it's like, you know, $14.
But I did get to sample quite a few of the cocktails. I had the blue piranha, which is, it's, I don't know, I liken it to like, and I could be wrong, I'm not like a total cocktail aficionado, but it was a little bit like a blue Hawaiian, but frozen, so kind of coconut, kind of pineapple, frozen, and then they put a strawberry puree, you know, like it's a piranha attack, whatever, and then they put the fruit, and it's delicious. It's really, I had that cocktail, I had a Krakatoa, I had, I did at the last night, we did pina colada with Sailor Jerry float.
What?
So good. I love Sailor Jerry.
Yum.
Kind of basic rum, but
super
love it. It was, yeah, because you get that little spicy, and yeah, it was really good. And then they have the tiki rum is what they call it, and it's like, it tastes basically, you guys, like a painkiller. Like, it's got the cinnamon, the nutmeg, and it's heavy on the coconut. It's kind of creamy. Pineapple juice.
I like it.
It's delicious. Anyway,
it's
so,
making me thirsty for tiki drinks.
Maybe we should go hit up the Jungle Bird and go see our Ohana. Maybe we should.
Yeah, maybe we'll do that. We may go early because we might have to go hit the pool later too.
Is that the plan?
I feel like that could be a plan.
Okay. Because I'm also thinking live band karaoke every Sunday.
Well,
at
if we don't get our hair wet,
we could do both.
We can do.
How are we going to cram this all in, you guys?
I
don't even know.
I am like the crammer of everything.
I'm the crammer of things.
Yes. So, yeah, I'm super jealous. I've never been to Trader Sam's.
You'll get to go.
I'll have to go.
We'll get to go
one time.
When we go to Vegas, we can like stop through.
We can go.
And then, okay. We'll just make it a whole trip.
Are we going the LA way, or we're not going to Vegas the Reno way?
No.
Oh, because I heard everyone goes that way.
I don't care.
Yeah, I think the LA way is better because you have better, like, views. I mean, you could stop.
Well, places. And I feel like, I mean, yeah, I like going, you know, I like going to, I mean, because I'll, usually if I'm going to go and drive all that way, I like to cram in some shows, right? So I'll, like, hit up, like, you know, Long Beach or Huntington Beach or Anaheim, and then, you know, maybe stay a night or two there, and then go to Vegas, right?
I feel like I want to put my hair up. I'm hot right now.
Flipping hot.
I know. I washed my hair.
I know.
Last night
like,
too,
it's
so.
Tempting to shave one's Ugh. Head, but then you can't have fancy hair if you shave your head.
How would you put your flowers on?
Exactly.
You'd have to like glue
tape
them on.
Velcro?
Yeah. You'd have to get sticky Velcro that sticks to your head and then Velcro your flower.
That just makes me think when I was a wee baby, I was a baldy. Like, I mean, I was born like super towhead blonde and I didn't have a lot of hair to begin with. And like, I think my mom told me that I was like pretty much bald till I was like 2. Sad story. My mom would like literally scotch tape bows to my head. That's a true story. You're welcome. Yeah, because, you know, people would be like, oh, he's so cute, you know, because I was bald. Mm-hmm. I didn't have the luscious locks like my children's. My children's
yes,
had, like,
they have good hair.
They were, like, born all little munchy cheese, yep. Like, crazy native beautiful hair.
Babies.
Gorgeous, gorgeous, yeah. Good hair. I don't know.
So,
there's Lloyd. Hi, Lloyd.
Hey, Lloyd.
Are you back from Europe now, Lloyd?
I think he is.
Yeah, how's Spencer doing?
Diana's watching, too.
Hey, Diana.
Hi, Diana.
Smoochies, smoochies. I love you. I miss you.
I do too.
It was really cute. You sent me that invite to come swim at the pool, but I was literally going to a movie at that same time. I went and saw the Tarantino flick.
I thought we were going to do that together.
What?
She invited me and then she goes by herself. I guess I'll have to go see it myself.
I am fucking brain dead lately. Like, I am brain dead.
It's because she was drinking all those tiki drinks.
Probably. I lost my shit. I am telling everyone, though, I'll go watch it 5 times. It's that much fun. I will go watch that film 5 freaking times.
It's that much fun.
I will go spend all of the money. I love Tarantino anyway.
I love.
And he nailed it. It's a little, like, I have to say, like, I was, like, there was a couple times I felt like I was kind of getting lost. Like, what is happening and why is it going this way? There, you know, because he does that, right? He does chapters kind of like.
Yeah.
Where you're like, wait, what does this have to do with anything? And there were some slow bits, but it does all lead to somewhere. And I mean, it's just so visually, even if the story gets slow at times, it's so visually gorgeous. Mm-hmm. I did not want to leave the theater for real. Like, I was like, I mean, there's neon and there's mid-century architecture and there's gorgeous American cars and there's a kick-ass 60s soundtrack and there's gorgeous clothes and there's beautiful people. I mean, can you tell I liked it? It was really good. I will watch it 5 times, for real. Who wants to go? Let's go. Viewing party.
Speaking about people you love.
Yes. Oh, oh yes, please and thank you.
So I got this in the mail a couple of weeks ago, and I didn't
bring
it last week.
And now I'm jelly because I didn't order it.
And they're limited. I don't know if it's sold out because I haven't seen, but again,
so
please be in love right now.
Holy snap.
Love, love, love.
Oh, look, it doesn't need the thingy in the middle. You don't have to have a thingy.
Yeah, I think sometimes they make them with the smaller holes.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Because then you can just not worry about that.
Limited edition.
Gorgeous red vinyl. Ooh. Delicious.
So delish. I was excited when I got this.
Very good.
It came really fast. I saw my friends that live in Canada had received theirs, and I'm like, what? And they said, order it. They said they're selling, like, out.
So
I ordered it, and then
next week we should listen to it. We've been wanting to do this. I think we're going to do, like, a 45 party, right? I'll get some of my new 45s, and she'll bring her new 45s. It's just, like, I don't want to, like, go over here and, like, have to change the record all the time.
And since we're on the colored vinyl, mojo.
Yeah.
So, we had a couple of weeks ago, 3 weeks probably at this point, Elvis Cantu played at the Momo Lounge, his first ever Momo Lounge appearance.
I changed the record, you guys.
Just gotta change the record.
Side 3 is coming up.
So there is a friend that he brought with him. His name is Sean Law. He is a DJ. He is also...
And I think we became best friends.
Yeah, and what is...
We love him. He's awesome.
He's the... he's the owner.
He is, the founder/owner of both Jinx Records,
mm-hmm.
Jinx Records and Rockin' Records. And he is just a swell dude. And, you know, I mean, he's got really good taste in music and amazing selection of music.
Absolutely.
And
he was kind enough to sell me one of the records, which you can buy these at in San Francisco. What is that? Amoeba.
Yeah. They have a good selection of Rockin' Records at Amoeba. I was there not very long ago.
But this is a Smurf.
Look at it!
45.
Yeah, look, I can be like this. Look at this. gorgeous.
And it is from, the band is Pretty Boy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
By the Wild Tones.
Yes. That's Wild the song. Tones. The Wild Tones are the band.
Yeah, we have to have a 45 party next week. We're doing
this. This is a cool little album because it's in this cool little cover. Like, you see the art. Okay.
It's really cool too. It's got some good marketing for this.
And it comes with release.
Yeah, check it out.
What? So you can actually see it all. And it's all weird. The faces, everything's
so
weird.
So weird.
So weird.
We were doing it at the show. We he had a pair of the glasses in his little record stash and he was letting us put them on.
Yes.
It's pretty cool.
So
he's kind of a marketing genius. I kind of really dig that.
Super, super cool.
Yeah.
And because he knows I'm a little bit obsessed with colored vinyl, he decided to kick down another album. And we were like, yellow. And he was like, no, it's, what did he say? It's egg yellow, like an
totally egg yolk.
I'm getting to call.
Why are you calling right now?
Why
don't
are
call
you calling
right now.
Private caller.
Anyway,
this is a really cool color, and this is, by Hurricane Felix and the Southern Twisters.
So I've heard good things about that band.
So we're going to have to listen to it.
And that is one of the records that you can, if I'm not mistaken, you can pick this up at Amoeba Records.
Yes.
We don't have it here in Sacramento. We've got it like that. But you can, San Francisco, record shopping. It is the most fun.
Yeah.
So much fun.
So those are our little treats. And we'll listen to them next week. I'll leave them there.
Yeah, that's what we're going to do.
I'll leave, my Delta Bombers.
Record party.
And then, whatever new stuff you've got.
Uh-huh.
And, so exciting.
That'll be fun.
This makes me happy.
Records. Vinyl.
Colored vinyl, records, and music in general.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And so yesterday, our friend had a record sale.
Yeah, so Armadillo Records, going back to the Armadillo in Davis, California, is one of the last stands for her really interesting, weird, and rare vinyl records. It's a small-ass little record store, but they're independent, and they're doing it. They're doing it. Paul Wilbur is the manager there. He's a good pal of ours, and that guy can hook you up with pretty much anything you want. And he does, and I want to say it's every 6 months. Is it? I think I want to say, it's either quarterly or it's twice a year.
I want to say quarterly, because I feel like we just went not too long ago.
It was like February. We were both freezing. Do you not remember? It was raining. It was cold as shit when we went.
The weather's here is weird. So
okay, the weather is weird. But anyway, over at, he does a big crate dig. It's like all kinds of random, weird, all kinds of weird stuff. And it's at Sudwerk in Davis, which is like a big brewery place.
Mm-hmm.
So you can get your beer, walk around, see some friends, and then just do a serious crate dig.
It is fun. And you don't know what you're going to get. And there were a couple things I didn't pick up last time that she picked up. And then she ended up finding the same
ink spots.
Remember you found five records.
It's true that ink spots.
And she was like, oh my god, and it's like I saw them in different things and I think people were moving it around.
It's true.
And they all kind of ended up in one spot at
it's
one
true.
Point. But I picked up this Polynesian little
that is so awesome.
Double thing, double 45s, right? These are 45s.
Don't you love that? Yeah.
They're in pretty good shape. There's two of them.
Look at the artwork.
I mean, look.
The tiki.
So cool.
So
bitchin'. This one is really good. I've listened to it. And then I picked up this. I think we got these for we had stacks, so then I picked this up as well. And I think
cool.
The 45s were 25 cents or something weird like that.
Look, it's Raymond. Hi, Raymond.
So, I mean, you can always find cool little things
cool.
If you go to those record swaps.
True.
So, support
if you're
that
local,
too.
You know, hang out in Armadillo.
I'm sure they have
go to Armadillo
in
they
other
have,
spots.
They have, oh, totally. Oh, yeah, they're all over. Because, you know, my recent find in the world of vinyl, and I've already talked about it on here, but the Audio Nerd in Rockland.
Yeah.
We have to go. That guy is so
Well, yeah,
cool.
And then I brought this one last week. This
I know,
West
we have to
Sacramento.
Check that out, too. We haven't been, but
we haven't been there
out.
Yet, but we want to check it out.
Because vinyl. And if you have any secret squirrel spots for vinyl, kick it down and let us know.
Yeah.
Because we want to go and check it out, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for sure. So what's next. Let's
Do you want to look up and see what's going on?
We can. I did want to talk sort of briefly about, I don't know how much to even talk about it, but for all of you guys that know, we are putting on a tiki event on August 30th. We have the very distinct pleasure slash privilege of hosting Tikiaki 5-0. They're from Los Angeles. They're an exotica band. It is the smaller, stripped-down version of the Tikiaki Orchestra, who, as you guys may or may not know, play all of the big tiki festivals and events. And it's getting weird with the Beach Boys. I had to, like, stop. That harmony was cray cray. Sorry, I'm having a moment with the record over here. But anyway, so we're having this big, you know, tiki festival. It's called Night of the Living Tiki. You can find it on Facebook. There's an invite on Facebook. And there's a page on Facebook also, so you can get details about what's going on. But, I don't think I've ever worked so hard on any event trying to just make it happen. And all I can say about that is Sacramento. I can't with you. I just can't with you. What is wrong with you people? I'm just going to let you know there are some changes happening. There is going to be a venue change. I've received some emails regarding it because people are like, what is actually happening? The original venue, without getting too dirty pool and talking too much out of school, basically at the very last hour after agreements were in place, pulled out, demanded an astronomical figure of money. And I had to make a decision not to have it there because, I mean, the amount of money that they wanted would basically be like all of the entire budget for the bands, for everything. They got super weird and super greedy at the very last minute. They decided they couldn't accommodate us. And I'm just like, you people are super short-sighted. That's all I can think about that. Like, I'm not gonna talk a lot of smack, but the truth is like, I'm bringing to a not very popular bar at least 100 folk. And you're mad at that, and you need more money for that, and you need, like, I mean, it was ridiculous. And it was after agreements were already in place. Like, I already had everything set with the manager, and then it was some of the other staff that kind of decided to cause some issues. So that happened, and then
some people should just stay in the kitchen. Let's just say that.
True story. Figure out your eyebrows and go back to flipping burgers and shut your mouth. Okay. I said that. That's all I'm going to say. Okay.
We were told we shouldn't be so nice. So we're not. We're trying to
let a little bit of the bitch out. A little bit of the bitch. It's coming.
Because, you know, you need nice.
Well, and I mean, here's the thing. It's
sweet,
like,
and sour. Sweet and sour.
When you have an agreement in place with somebody and they have put somebody in charge.
Is a contract, fuckers.
No. I had three meetings with that place. Three. One, two, three.
A handshake. Is a contract.
And they agreed to everything, and everything was super groovy, and then they went home and thought about it, and some people freaked out and got their little sphincter in an uproar and decided that they needed to make my life a personal hell, basically. And it was ugly, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I didn't engage at all, but I'm just shocked. I guess I'm shocked slash dismayed that any venue in Sacramento that could benefit from an extra 100 or 150 folk said no. It's shocking.
You're shocked that Sacramento sucks?
Yeah, totally. So that happened. Then I took it to another venue, and they pretty similarly just couldn't come to terms, pretty similarly wanted, like, all these, like, different, you know, demands that's like, dude, like, you're going to make money on food and drink. Like, I'm bringing you 100 to 150 people that have never been here or don't come here, and you're mad at it. Like, it was just stupid. Anyway, I think I've got something else in place. We are gonna have a venue change. It's gonna be bigger, better, more room, more accommodating, more friendly. People that give a crap, people that want to participate. And that's the big thing. It's like, at the end of the day, you know, you don't wanna work with people that begrudgingly are allowing you and gracing you with their maybe not so wonderful establishment.
I just can't.
It's horrible. It's so bad.
I'm gonna go in there and eat some food and Yelp review it.
Boo!
Just saying. If you guys want to come with me, let's all do it. Let's do a group Yelp.
Yes. Just saying. Vote with your dollars, right? I mean, and that's it too. It's like, I'm like, once I let it out that this happened, all these people that, I mean, because I sell tickets to this event every single day. Like, this is going to probably be one of the bigger events I've ever done. And they are opting out of that, number one. But number two, they're going to piss all these people off. I'm like, you're stupid. Like, just suck it up. Even if you take a loss, which there was no chance of anybody taking a loss. This is going to be a great event. But even if that were a possibility, you're going to be gaining new fans, new customers, new people that are going to love you because you are the person that hosted the very first ever Tiki Festival in Sacramento.
Yep.
You're a dumbass if you don't see the potential in that. Like, I just can't. I don't even know what to say else about that, but it's just ridiculous. And, you know, Sacramento, get your shit together. That's all I can say. You know, there are people here with visions and dreams and goals and people who want to make things happen, and you're slamming doors on them left and right. And that's why we are a cultural void, and that is why our musicians have to play in Winters and Knight's Landing.
Winters. And Winters is getting banned.
And Knight's Landing.
And Knight's Landing.
And Stockton. And Grass Valley.
Stockton.
Because we can't make it happen here. Because everybody here just wants to grab their crotch and drink their craft brew and eat their bacon and call it a day. Nobody cares about what anybody else wants to do here. It's redonkulous. Like, guess what, guys? There's more to life than beer and farm to fork and bacon. There's more to life here in Sacramento on this grid. We are part of this grid. We live here and we're not going anywhere. So get with the program. Like, we want to make things happen. We want to have fun here. We want to enjoy the city that we live in. And it's just ridiculous how many closed slam doors we get in our face. Because what? You're all just so fat and happy and lazy that you just can't bother? Open your minds. Like, engage in the possibilities.
Well, let's just be real. If they want to have a DJ, a hip-hop DJ, any night of the week, that is Sacramento now.
Totally.
That is Sacramento.
Totally.
Or a heavy metal band at some of these venues. So there's a couple of venues that have been beautiful, beautiful. They're in beautiful buildings. They are beautiful, been around forever, and they've been multiple things. But a lot of people will buy them, and it's easy to slap a can of black paint all over everything and call it a metal bar. Now, instead of this beautiful, like, whatever, like, cool Victorian or whatever, I don't even know what the townhouse would have been considered back in the day, but their old decor that they had was
stucco,
so cool.
Yeah.
And then they threw on black paint all over the
vintage. They're
all,
hey, I went to a Hard Rock Cafe once. I'm going to make it like that, except it sucks and misses the mark.
Except for it's, you know, you're ruining, like, vintage tile, these bathrooms that have been here forever, these walls that are,
which, to be fair, nobody cares about the black paint except for a couple handful of us.
Hi, like, Ricky.
Hi.
And, so anyway, point being, slap on some black paint and call it a metal bar. Throw in
we
some dark
pizza.
Wood floors and call it a country bar. You know, it's kind of sad.
But worse than I think that, like, yes, that sucks. And I really hate that some of our, like, landmark places have been, like, swallowed up by this weird hipster corporate whatever the hell's going on. Like, it's sad and it's tragic, but more than that, these places that are just sitting there with their stupid karaoke night and their stupid DJ night and whatever they got going on, like, hey, guess what? There's more out there. You could potentially earn more. You could potentially make more money. You could potentially bring more people into your fold. Like, it's just because they're fat, they're happy, they're lazy, they don't give a shit, they can't see the forest for the trees, they have no vision. I mean, it's just, our venues are just, it's tragic. It's a tragic situation. Like, I get way more no than I do yes, and I mean, it would be different if
but
I was...
But you still fight for it, and that's
what
she does.
I will
she
always
fights
fight for
to
it.
Bring music to Sacramento any way that she can, and we, again, she's saying she's selling tickets every single day for this Tikiaki 5-0, and what kind of sucks is, you know, it's sold out technically once already, and you added more tickets. So, hello, people.
Potential.
Out there.
Potential. Yeah. And how about get behind it? And how about support it? And how about, like, just try something new? Like, of course, you know, your stupid nightly karaoke or trivia night or whatever the hell you got going on, it's working for you, great. But why not just open up to the possibility that maybe there's more potential? I mean,
so
I'm
instead
trying to
of five cars in your parking lot, let's just have 50 cars in your parking lot.
There's a thought. There's
how are you
going
to make money? Oh, the same five regulars that come to your bar?
Yeah, let's not mess with that. We don't want to piss them off. I don't even get it. I just can't. I don't know. Like,
this is why I go to the dive bars and that play actual vinyl and that I know that people love, they embrace it. Everyone's positive. Like, other places, it's like you really don't want to mess with your five regulars.
Right.
You're five. Okay.
Yeah,
on
I mean,
any
if you're gangbusters
weekend.
And you've got your joint filled up and there's people just eating and drinking 24/7 and you're happy and you're making hand over fist, Jason Boggs, like, good. That's awesome. Like, we support that. We love that. But if you're like some lackluster, maybe not in your heyday, maybe not in your prime bar, and I come to you and I'm like, I could bring you this, and you're like, boo-hoo, wah-wah, I can't do it. Shame on you. Shame on you.
This
shame.
Is the conflict that we needed in our show that we were told.
You're welcome.
So
here comes the big bitches.
I mean, it just like, it just, we just threw up all over you.
All over. That's why you tune in, right? Because you never know what's going to happen.
You never know. And there's
cuckoo.
Booze.
Cuckoo. It's true. There's wine and we're just going to start talking and it's just going to happen.
Anyway.
Let's kill this bottle, won't you?
Yeah,
let's kill it. Kill it.
Might as well. It gets better. It gets better as you drink it. Like, I feel like this is really good wine now. It tastes like wine.
Well, I feel like maybe.
Also, I haven't eaten today.
I know.
I haven't had any coffee and
dork. I feel like maybe, though, it's, I don't know, maybe rosé aerates, right? I mean, maybe all wine does. I don't know that much about it. I just like drinking it. Cheers.
Okay, so do we want to look up some stuff?
Cause yeah.
We want to let you know what's going on, but I have to say I'm super, super jelly.
Of?
There was an event in Los Angeles last night that our good friends the Out of Sights played.
Oh, that was the night before last, though.
Oh, was it the night
before?
Okay,
because wait, today's Sunday, Saturday,
it was Saturday.
Friday.
I thought it was Saturday.
No, because I talked to Chris yesterday.
Oh, well, anyway, point being,
good
it was a great tiki, what was it called? The tiki something, right?
The tiki Ogogo. With Bunny Cacciatore and Susie Cream Cheese.
It was so...
So, like,
the videos are so good.
Yeah, it looked amazeballs.
And our
Chris,
Out of Sights
Chris
friend
actually,
brought
because I talked to him on the phone, I guess that was yesterday, he said it was one of the best shows the Out of Sights have ever played.
It looked amazing.
He said it was so good.
Chris, we love you, Chris.
We do love you.
Oh, my
we
God.
Do.
It looked amazing. And I was so jealous that I wasn't there.
He told me
like, how
that
am I not there? Like, I don't
it
know.
It felt like Sunset Strip, Whiskey a Go-Go, 1960s. He said that there was, like, they did one of those oil, you know, the oil light shows where they put the projector and they, like, all hippie, trippy, acid, weird, you know,
so
projector.
Good.
Yeah.
It looks so much fun.
Yeah. I know. It was killing me that I was down there and couldn't stay one more night and
go.
Oh,
man.
That was killing me.
I would have been mad.
I came back on Thursday. And
I would have been like, we were supposed to be there this
we
weekend,
talked
though.
About it. We talked about
we
it.
We were supposed
yeah.
to be there.
We were.
Yeah.
Four?
We were going to DJ possibly.
Oh, yeah. But happy birthday, Penny. Yeah, no, it looked like that was a good party. Vicky Tafoya played.
She did?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
That looked like a really good party. That we weren't
awesome.
At.
Yeah. Oh, well. Because now we were in Sacramento in 105 degree weather dying.
Fighting it out
while she's at the
shithole
movies.
Venues.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good times. Good times. So this is side four of this awesome four record set. And we love the Beach Boys. They are a party.
Oh. No, we don't want to talk to you.
No, Siri, go away.
Siri.
That's my phone.
Hey,
so sorry. Oh, yeah.
Let's see
we're
going to
do
what's
events.
Going on.
Okay, so like I said, you guys, the big event that we have going on is August 30th. It's a Friday. We have Tikiaki 5-0 is going to be there. And
when is that Green River thing? Is that today?
Green River.
Is that from last week? Notes, Green River.
Yeah, that's from last week.
But was that today or
no? No, that
or?
Was that was yesterday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday, out in Winners, Mike played it.
Winners.
Winters.
Yep. Because Sacramento can't hang. Stupid Sacramento.
Winters. I know. I just got a message this morning for Junior Brown.
Yeah, and it's not in Sacramento. Because nothing is in Sacramento. But speaking of far-flung, retarded out places, the Trocaderos are playing today. I think it's happening. It's actually happening right now. They're playing in Knights Landing.
Oh, okay.
At the Stingrays Marina.
Okay.
And I think they're doing 2 or 3 sets, and I think it is free. Oh, here it is. Yeah, here it is. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, 12 to 3 today at Stingrays, which I still haven't been to, but guess what? I don't really want to drive to Knights Landing, but you know what?
I've driven to Knights Landing in the fog.
I have
to see the Hucklebucks by myself. Crazy.
Was it like a
January?
Horror movie?
I thought I was going to die or run someone over, and then they'd come home with me and be like, thanks for the ride, lady, and murder me in my garage.
So, yeah, the Jungle Bird is today. The Trocaderos are today. Anybody who wants to go see the Trocaderos out at the Stingrays Marina, good times. We will probably go by. We're going to go to the Ohana, right? We're going to go get a mug. Yeah, we're going to go do that.
We're going to go get a mug.
And then we have...
We'll support... that even though I have issues.
Oh my goodness.
With that.
We know, because it's not perfect. They're still working out the kinks. What's this?
I don't love it.
Friday, August 2nd. Like a Rocket, Cole Hinkle, and the Rio Linda Troubadour. That looks like fun.
Where is that at?
Oh, so this is the new Angel's Front Porch. This is at Kim's Place in Rio Linda.
Okay.
It's 7261 10th Street, Rio Linda. With Cole Hinkle and Amy Estelle. That looks like a dang old party. $10 at the gate goes directly to the artist. Raffle prizes all ages and family friendly. BYOB. Okay. That sounds like fun. I would. Duck water! That sounds like fun. I'm down for that. That sounds like fun times. Oh! We should say again, August 3rd, we
I don't know what just happened.
We are going to go, I had a little light bulb turned on, but we're going to go to see Cashed Out. Cashed Out is coming from LA, and they're going to be at Harlow's.
So that's Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
I am double booked that day.
I am.
I'm going to see a show in Folsom. It's called Little Black Dress. I'm going with my friend Shannon. Okay. And so that's
after?
At 2. Oh, so I'll be like,
ooh,
it'll probably be a couple hours. I'm just going to be dressed for the day.
Okay.
I'll probably wear a black dress.
we'll both wear black dresses.
I mean, like, Cashed Out, black, man in black
so
dress.
So, like, Western / black is good.
Ooh, if I can find some fringe from my dress in the next week to add it to.
I have a little black cowboy hat I could do.
I have a little cowboy hat that I can do that I won when I was... in a pinup.
That's true. You could, like, the little clip it on with the tiara on it. That would be so cute. Yeah. You should. Okay. We're working on outfits. We're working on. Yep. Who's coming with us? We're going to have so much fun at Harlow's. We have a booth.
Yes, we have
a
booth.
It's going to be a ton of us.
Oh, so if you are our friends and you are coming to that show and you want to pitch in for the booth, let us know. Hit us up.
That same day, it's killing me. Hank Williams Jr. is playing at the Nugget.
I know.
In Reno. I want to go to Reno.
We can't do it all.
Holy crap. So listen, if you live in Reno, please go to that show, take some videos, share it with us, because I want to go to that. That's so cool.
I know.
I want to go to that. Also on August 3rd, there's too many things. Feast or Famine Sacramento, get your shit together. Casey Hensley is playing at the Torch Club on the 3rd.
But that's later. So Cashed Out is earlier. We could probably do both.
Okay.
Because, you know, the parental units will want to go home.
Yep.
And then we can go to Torch.
Yeah, so that starts at 9. So we can go to Cashed Out and then go hit this up at the Torch Club. Yeah, okay. Party. That's what we're doing. We're doing that.
Yes.
Okay. So also coming up on August 4th, a Sunday, Valstar and the Blues Rocket.
Where is that at?
Lager Restaurant?
Where is that?
I don't know. I don't even know where that is.
I don't know where that is.
It's at the hotel. How do you say that? Leisure?
Leisure.
Yeah. Oh.
I know.
En français.
En français.
restaurant and saloon. It's 46 miles away from us. That's a little bit far. There's some of our friends are going though. That looks like fun.
But Packard I just want to say also, on the same music note, my good pal, our good pal, our good pals, Diana and the Cherry Kings have their first show coming up at the Shady Lady.
Oh, we're going to be there.
Yes, thank you, Daniel, for making that happen. I totally appreciate you. And thank you for, I bugged him so much. I'm like, you better,
Diana.
Yeah, okay, and so.
When?
It's in September. And
oh, the 28th, I think.
Yes, and there's a, she's already put an event up. So we'll share that, but it is going to be fun.
I just got a little message. August 3rd in Davis at the 3 Mile Brewing.
So same day?
Oh. Good God. You guys, I can't do everything.
Well,
I can't do
everything. We'll be at Cashed Out and Torch Club.
Okay, so Twilight Drifters at 3 Mile Brewing at on August 3rd.
3 Mile Brewing?
Yeah.
In Davis?
In Davis!
That's our brewery.
That's our brewery.
That's our record brewery.
That is our brewery. So we maybe, I mean, I don't know. What time? Oh, three. He said three, right?
Yeah, three. Okay. I mean, I'm going to be somewhere else. But
because you have to go to Folsom.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
That's a lot.
That is a lot. But you could. Oh, no, you can't because Cashed Out is at the same
time. I'm literally going to be driving from Folsom, driving home.
Okay.
The doors are at 6.
I could maybe catch one set 30. If I go there because the Cashed Out thing starts at like 5, musicals start at 6. So I could do 3 o'clock in Davis, then go to Cashed Out, and then go to Torch Club because I'm cuckoo. I could
do
it.
Well, I'm doing the same thing you're doing though, too.
You are?
Like literally, I'm going to be at an event.
True.
Come down. True. From Folsom. Like it's pretty
this
much.
This is how much we love my live music. Can you tell? Like this is what we do. We love this. This is what we do. Okay, so Damn Liars are also playing on the 4th Sunday, and that's going to be at the Corner Pocket Sports Bar, which I don't think I've ever heard
of. Oh, is that off of Fulton?
It's in Citrus
Heights. Oh, Sunrise.
And it's Sunrise
Corner Boulevard. Pocket is like a pool hall.
So 3 o'clock, early show, Sunday fun day.
Ooh.
So much fun
on the
Sunday. We
could do that after our show.
Ooh, we could. Okay. Oh, okay. That would be so much fun.
See, are we excited? Are you excited? We're excited.
So excited. I What's mean, this?
Why did I ask?
What the hell is this? And I'm going to this. I'm going to this. Los Tiki Phantoms at Momo on Monday.
Do we need to get our tickets?
Yeah, we need tickets. Oh, my God.
We'll get our tickets when we go to Cashed Out.
Oh, my God. We have to go to
There's
this.
More stuff happening. Oh, my
you
God.
Guys,
send me that.
Like, look at this. Like, what? Los Tiki Phantoms. I'm so going to that. Super
and the Momo
fun.
Lounge shows are a little more intimate than the Harlow shows, which I love.
You guys are from Argentina with Megustas. Megustas are from Sacramento.
Argentina.
Oh my God, that's going to be so the good show, you guys. We're totally going to that. Okay, so we didn't really cover that many events, though. I feel like.
No, but we covered enough.
Today. We did. We did.
We covered enough.
So much good music.
Mostly so third, fourth, and fifth.
It's true.
Of August.
It's coming right up at you, though.
And next week we'll be more prepared.
Maybe. Probably not. There will just be other booze and we'll just be silly again. But whatever. In the meantime, you guys, if you have any shows and you want us to share, please do hit us up. We're both on Instagram. We're both on Facebook. Shonda Honkinen.
Wait, am I on Facebook?
You're on Facebook.
Oh. I don't want to
And Instagram.
I'm on the DL.
She's even... You can't... Have you seen this? You can't miss this. You'll find this. But she's also on Instagram. We have an Instagram
Diva
together.
Diva5150, and then we have Wine Women and Song.
On the Insta.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So you can find us there. And then also on the YouTube, you guys know Wine Women and Song on YouTube.
Yes.
Please subscribe. We are always begging for our subscribers because we're trying to get to that 1,000 mark.
Plus,
so hard to do. It's grueling.
We tell you to tell us what you want to see or if you want us to drink something or if you have a band, if you want to send us a record and we can play it or whatever.
Well, wear your t-shirt. Wear your hat.
Listen.
We'll talk about
We want to be able to like talk about stuff and green screen stuff. And this is why we're trying to do the, you know, get on the YouTube. Get on the
we
YouTube.
We are on the YouTube currently.
We need the subscribers to be able to
we
do more
stuff. We need
1,000
subscribers. Well, we can do things like stream live on YouTube, which we currently can't do. That's why we record here on Facebook, and then we upload it to the YouTube every week.
Yes.
So as soon as this is over, I'll be uploading it there. And if you go to the YouTube, just so you know, I say it every week, But we have not just our episodes, which, I mean, we have 27 episodes now, probably more than you ever want to watch in your lifetime, but we also have really awesome footage of all of the shows that we go to. So if you're a live music fan, you can go see some of these bands that we're talking about right on our YouTube. It's like a whole, you can just go down the line and see all kinds of really exciting, good music.
Yeah, I think that's fun thing to do. I like to watch the old ones to see how much we've changed. Because I am normally not a good, I'm still not really good at
She's
it.
Amazing.
But like, I don't like a lot of attention.
She's a liar. Big fat liar.
But I mean, in the beginning, I think I was a little more shy. Yeah.
Me too. You know, this is, I wouldn't even.
She's like not so knowledgeable about everything.
I would not even be doing this if not for this gal, because she's the one at the show. She's like, no, you get up there, you go announce that band. You get up there, you go talk about that band. You get up there, you go talk to them. I was always terrified for anybody to even look at me.
Let's get a selfie with the band.
And she's now like, we do. But I was always very like self-conscious and didn't want people to look at me. I don't want people to know who I am and what I'm doing. And so I get what you're saying, even though we're super extra, right? You can't miss us. Like, you cannot miss us. But it's like, now I feel like we're both evolving as a result of doing this, which is, you know, hey, start a podcast, webcast with your best friend, because it'll
maybe
be your
someday good. I'll learn how to speak well.
You're amazing. Shut up. She's amazing.
I just ramble, and sometimes I forget what I
you know what matters is you really care about music. That's what cares, and that's what matters.
Even though sometimes I can't express myself totally completely, because I get so excited, and I think I have early onset Alzheimer's. I forget a lot of
stuff. You're a hot mess.
I am a hot mess. And when it's 105 here, and you have freshly washed hair, and it's a wreck, and and it's down, and and you're drinking Andre champagne.
That's flat. It's not that bad though. It does get better.
it does get better. The more you drink it,
it's not. We love it. We absolutely love it.
This is the best ever rosé
ever.
It's so good. Oh my God, so good.
But anyway, you guys, meanwhile, listen, seriously, write us a private message. We love to get your messages. We love to get your feedback. We love to hear what you want to see and what you want us to cover. And if you're in a band, if you have a brand of something and you want us to, you know, shout you out, talk about it, we are so open to your suggestions.
Also, share us with your friends on Facebook.
I mean, if
you're laughing at us right now, let your friends laugh at us too.
Sharing is caring, bitches. Sharing is caring. Yeah, let it happen. Just let it happen.
I think we are about done.
And the record's almost over.
I think we killed the wine. Oh, we did kill the wine.
Yeah, we did.
I think we went a little bit over today. Or did we start late? I don't remember.
I don't think so. But for all of you that are local, if you want to go hit up the Ohana, we're going to go at least say hi. Gotta go give Kurt a hug and say hi to Wiley and all of our pals over there. Maybe have a little Dole Whip. It's a perfect day for Dole Whip.
I was going to wear my Dole Whip earrings today, and I couldn't find the other one.
So, true story, in Disneyland, I broke one of mine. The ear wire. Well, I didn't break it. It, like, came off the ear wire, and it's, like, at the hotel where I was staying.
I only have one. And I was like, I could have done one, I guess. I haven't just been like this.
I like the little yellow numbers. Yeah. I like these glitter numbers. Look at these.
Yeah,
little.
I love those.
Oh, I love these. I love them.
So anyway, people,
I think that just about does it, guys. Have a great day. Get the most out of your weekend.
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us. We love your support. We love you. And go make magic happen. Have a great day. We love you. We'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye, guys. I'm trying to press the thing.